try these questions from CXC CSEC multiple choice mathematics examination. Remember, calculators are not allowed in this exam. To get the most out of this video, pause it here and resume when you have an answer for each question. Okay, let's go. Question 1. The vector A is equal to 3, negative 2. The vector B is equal to negative 1, 2. Therefore, 2A minus 3B is equal to 2 multiplied by 3, negative 2, minus 3 multiplied by negative 1, 2. 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 6. 2 multiplied by negative 2 is equal to negative 4. Minus 3 multiplied by negative 1 is negative 3. And 3 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6. 6 minus negative 3 is the same as 6 added to positive 3. So we get 9. And negative 4 minus 6 is equal to negative 10. The answer is C. Question 2. P multiplied by Q is equal to 1, negative 2, 1, 3, multiplied by negative 2, 1, 3, 0. Matrix multiplication is done row by column. We multiply the first row by the first column to get the first row, first column of the answer. We have 1 multiplied by negative 2 added to negative 2 multiplied by 3. We multiply the first row by the second column to get the first row, second column of the answer. 1 multiplied by 1 added to negative 2 multiplied by 0. We multiply the second row by the first column to get the second row, first column of the answer. 1 multiplied by negative 2 added to 3 multiplied by 3. And we multiply the second row by the second column to get the second row, second column of the answer. 1 multiplied by 1 added to 3 multiplied by 0. Simplifying, 1 multiplied by negative 2 is negative 2 added to negative 2 multiplied by 3, negative 6. Negative 2 added to negative 6 is equal to negative 8. 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1, and negative 2 multiplied by 0 is 0. 1 added to 0 is 1. 1 multiplied by negative 2 is negative 2 added to 3 multiplied by 3 is 9. Negative 2 added to 9 is the same as 9 take away 2, which is equal to 7. And 1 multiplied by 1 is 1. Added to 3 multiplied by 0 is 0. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. The answer is negative 8, 1, 7, 1. The answer is C. Question 3. The transformation maps A, 3, 5 onto A prime, 3, negative 5. Sketching quickly. A would be here. And A prime would be here. Looks like a reflection in the x-axis. If we have committed the matrices that describe each transformation to memory, we know that D is a reflection in the x-axis. A is a unit matrix and would map a point onto itself. B is not one of the common transformations. And C can be a reflection in the origin. or a rotation of 180 degrees about the origin, or a reflection in the line y is equal to negative x, that would put e prime here, etc. So we know that the answer is D. If we didn't memorize these, we'd have to multiply each out to see which one is the answer. So trying A, we have 1001 multiplied by 35. One multiplied by 3, added to 0 multiplied by 5 is equal to 3. And 0 multiplied by 3, 0, added to 1 multiplied by 5 is 5. So we'd get back itself. Is B correct? One multiplied by 3 is 3. Added to negative 1 multiplied by 5, negative 5, 3 added to negative 5 is equal to negative 2. 0 multiplied by 3 is 0, added to 1 multiplied by 5 is 5. So the second matrix would map the point 3, 5 to the point negative 2, 5, which is not the answer. And C, negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1. Would map the point onto negative 1 by 3 is negative 3, added to 0 is negative 3. And 0 multiplied by 3 is 0, added to negative 1 multiplied by 5, negative 5. And then D would give us what we're looking for. One multiplied by 3 is equal to 3, add to 0 multiplied by 5, 0. 3 plus 0 is equal to 3. And 0 multiplied by 3 is 0, add it to negative 1 multiplied by 5, negative 5, which is equal to negative 5. As we said before, the matrix 1, 0, 0, negative 1 maps 3, 5 onto 3, negative 5. So again, the answer is D. Question 4 is equal to 6, 6 minus 3, 2. It's equal to 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. The answer is A. The vector PT is equal to PS added to ST. PS is equal to A. And ST is equal to negative B. Note that the arrow points from T to S, so ST will be the negative of B. A added to negative B is the same as A subtract B, which is equal to A is equal to 4, 3, and B is equal to negative 2, 1. 4 minus negative 2 is equal to 4 added to positive 2, so we get 6, and 3 subtract 1 is equal to 2. The answer is C. I am Mr. Dube. Post a comment. Let me know how you are managing. If you found this video useful, please like this video. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. Join me in the next video.